Oh, that's a different light. I was about to be like, what? Okay. I totally forgot to mention that I took an edible before filming this. Dear Lord. Hey everyone, it's me, Yasmin, and I am finally back with another video. I know that I was going to be consistent last year. I really was. My plan was to be consistent. But what I realize is that a plan cannot be a plan unless if you actually have a plan. I just had the plan, I'm gonna be consistent. But there was no in-between steps of actually like pursuing to be consistent. Once school started, all of that was just out the window. So this time, when I say I am actually ready to do YouTube, I mean it, and I'll get more into that with the actual topic of this video. If you've never been to my channel, this is my late night car talks, where I talk about either one certain topic or I talk about multiple different topics within the same umbrella, or just a rant about random stuff. This episode is going to be about 2022 goals / resolution. Yes, very typical and very cliche, but at the same time, I feel like as everyone is starting to get settled within the new year, I would like to also share my 2022 goals / resolutions. I never really made a thoroughly fleshed out list of goals before from previous years. It's always kind of been like a mental checklist in my head of things that I want to achieve, but I've never really actually like wrote them down or typed them in my notes or anything like that where I could actually look at them as they're tangible. And I also really, really, really wanted to start this year off with knowing the things that I can achieve and will achieve, as well as things that I want to do. Like when it comes to 2022 new, you know, resolutions and goals and things, people have this incredible pressure that they put upon themselves where they feel as though they need to do things that they feel as though they should be doing. I've been looking at this in more so of like not of what I should be doing, but more so of what I want to do, and not to blame myself or shame myself for not doing that. You always hear the typical, and then you're good for like the first week or month, and then it's just like bleh. Because people don't necessarily think about what they can actually achieve and what's tangible for them, as well as what they will actually enjoy. That's why it kind of falls off, and that's why people can't stay consistent, is because they try to put themselves into boxes that don't fit with their specific needs and wants. Anyways, with me, I really wanted to think about what I wanted to, what my three words were going to be for this year. And Amy Lee, she's actually a life coach. She's a YouTuber as well. That's how I found her. But she now does life coaching. And she had this word cross puzzle that she had on her Instagram, and I'll pop it up onto the screen whenever, so you guys can see what your three words are for the new year. My three words were healing, liberation, and support. And I honestly do feel as though that is a very great way of encompassing of what I really want to do this year. I do know that last year was a lot of grieving. It was a lot of grieving. And so while we're coming into this new year and I'm still feeling the kind of ickiness and all that great stuff when it comes to events in your life that aren't necessarily the greatest, and it doesn't feel that great in your body or for your mentality, this year is going to be me focusing more on just the inner aspects of myself and healing myself with the things I enjoy to do, healing my inner child, healing my generational trauma wounds, things that like that, that obviously isn't going to be completed in this year. It's basically like a lifetime type of effort, but at least I know that I'm headed onto the right direction in order to achieve what I want to achieve in my life. I know everyone says this. Everyone's like, it's gonna be my year. 2022 is gonna be my year. I get that everyone says that, but I honestly feel as though 2022 is going to be my year, especially with me becoming 21, becoming more of an adult, experiencing more experiences, and just living my life more. I honestly believe that is going to be a joyful year. And I'm just fucking excited. Before I talk my head off more, I am going to actually start the video. Okay? Number one, become more sustainable. I honestly, have been looking more deeper within of how I affect the earth and my carbon footprint and the things that I can do in order to feel as though I am making an impact in my own circle when it comes to helping the earth and just loving the earth the way that it's supposed to be and taking care of the earth as us humans are supposed to be doing. When I think of sustainability, I don't only think of like not using plastic or using wooden spoons or glass containers and things like that. That is totally in the package, but I also think it's a mindset as well. I want to be more aware of what I'm spending money on, who I'm giving my money to. Am I investing into local businesses or am I continuously putting money into the pockets of big corporations that don't give a fuck about people and are the reason why we're in the fucking mess that we are in with climate change? I honestly believe that I can do better when it comes to these things. And of course, I'm going to make mistakes here and there, but I do want to become extremely more aware and mindful of what I'm doing in terms of my place here on this earth. I just hope that by the end of this year, I can say, yeah, I did a lot better than I've done before. And that's my goal, pretty much. Number two, being consistent with YouTube. Like I was just ranting about, I have always wanted to do YouTube. I've never had an actual plan on how to do YouTube, but I always knew that that was something that I wanted to do. And this time around, I actually sat my ass down and wrote a list of videos throughout the year so I wouldn't have to worry about every month or so of what videos I need to put out. I believe that the list that I have is an actual pretty good list. I think there's probably gonna be some changes here and there throughout the year depending on what situations and events happen. But overall, I'm actually really excited for the videos I have planned this year. I'm really excited to actually do YouTube. I enjoy filming, I enjoy editing, I enjoy how open and creative I can be when it comes to this platform, and I just want to do that more because I feel as though with living in a capitalistic society, I think that it's easy for me to get into the mindset of just the hustle and just get your 9-to-5 and stick with that and go to school and stick with that, while I'm just like, well, I want to do more. I want to do a lot more than just those two things. And honestly, the way that my life is going, I can honestly achieve all three of those aspects in my life, and that makes me pretty happy. Number three, home cooking a lot more. If you would look at my finances, you would see that I spend an incredible amount of money on DoorDash. Besides my bills that take up more than half of my paychecks, It's actually mind-boggling of how much I can spend with takeout food. It's funny to me because every time I home cook, every single time I cook my own food, I always think, this shit tastes better than any sort of takeout food I can get. At least around here. I wouldn't really say that if I lived in an area that had like bomb-ass food. In this town, we don't have like bomb-ass food. We have decent food and pretty good food, but we don't have food that's like, I wanna go there again. It's not like the Bay Area. Don't even get me started on the Bay Area. I can't even speak about the Bay Area. Home cooking a lot more is definitely something that I want to do because I, first of all, really enjoy it. It's an act of self-love for me. I know that I'm nourishing my body with the ingredients that I'm using. I also am enjoying baking. I have been doing for the past few weeks and it's been really, really stress relieving. And it's just such a great way to spend time with yourself without any distractions. Yes, sometimes I'll put on music or sometimes I'll watch like a YouTube video or things like that. It's a great quality time with yourself. And I wanna do that more. Number four, tattoos. I want to get tattoos so bad this year, and I'm going to. I really just have to put money aside in order to get my tattoos that I want done. I also follow the specific artist. Her books, like her, it's a very small window of when her books are open, and I always look to see like when she does her flash tattoos that she's doing over time, and I always just think when there's the right one, I am going to have the money to get that tattoo. Until her official books opened, and then I can actually like go and get a tattoo that I want that's not her specific style. I just want to be tatted this year. I'm not sure if I'm gonna start with my hand because I was thinking of getting hand tattoos. I do know that I want to get some hand tattoos on both of my hands because hand tattoos just look really cool. And I really enjoy that. I was thinking of either starting big because I do know I want to get a spine tattoo eventually. And I was like, should I just nip it in the bud and just get that first? But I don't know. I feel as though that might be too overwhelming for me with my first tattoo. So I should just start small. But that is definitely a thing that I want to do. And I just have to save money for it. I just have to set aside money to get it done. That's all I gotta do. Number five is spending time in nature more. I honestly believe that from the start of the pandemic back in 2020, my anxiety of going outside has increased dramatically, and that frustrates me so much. I enjoy spending time in nature. That is something that I enjoy to do. But especially with where I live, people don't take, how should I say this? People just don't care. With that, it makes me super uncomfortable and not enjoy my time outside because I'm just like, I don't want to be around people. But then I thought, well, Yasmin, you can go to places that aren't around people. You can spend time going to certain hiking areas and just be in the forest and things like that where I'll have to drive and that's totally fine. But I just want to be able to spend more time outside and not feel scared or have an extreme amount of anxiety being outside. I just want to slowly get myself to become more aware of nature and just enjoying my time in nature, hearing or listening to how nature speaks to each other, having my feet, bare feet on the ground, doing some groundwork, breathing into the fresh air, just things like that that I feel as though is just such a special thing that we can do as human beings, and it's something that we're meant to do as human beings. We weren't really meant to be within boxes, you know? Like, our house is a box. We watch things on a box. We, either the phone or the TV, we're constantly in boxes physically. And so when it comes to nature, I feel like it teaches us so much more. And it teaches us so much about life in general. And I just want to hug trees more. Like, fuck, man. Like, I want to just become more in tune with nature and just be okay with silence too. I feel like that's something that I have struggled with, especially since I've stopped meditating. I used to do daily practices of meditation, But after like my breakup, I kind of just fell off the wagon, and just like, it's been difficult trying to get back into that state of like being okay with silence and being okay with like my inner dialogue, because my inner dialogue is so fucking loud, and it's just like, okay, we get it. With more time over this year and being more aware of nature, I think that everything will kind of just fall in place, and I'm really excited about that. And I honestly feel as though being in nature is just a spiritual experience in of itself, but that's just me speaking as an earth sign, so other people may think a bit differently. Number six, learning French. Je suis. Je suis Yasmin. That's literally all I can say in a sentence as of right now. Don't ask me for anything else. I'm still learning the ropes. I can't even pronounce R's yet. That's apparently something that's going to be a very difficult thing for me to do. It's a very difficult thing to do overall. I really just wanted to learn a different language this year, and I did choose French because I plan on taking a trip there one of these days. I don't have an exact date. I just know when I know that I'm going to do it, I'm going to do it. Not this year, definitely not this year. Definitely not next year, but probably sometime in 2024 or 2025. 2025 seems too long. 2024. Let's say that. 2024. yeah. So, okay. Everything's fine. It's just my lights literally turned off. I have four more. I don't want to keep the car on though. Number seven, dyeing my hair. I have such a love for my hair. The most dramatic thing I've ever done to my hair was cut it off, and that was such a big ordeal for me, especially since I come from a family where our hair is very we want to protect our hair basically, and anything that we might do to our hair that might jeopardize our natural beautiful hair is such a taboo thing. And so I remember when I cut off my hair, people were just like, oh my god, you didn't. And I'm just like, it's just hair, it'll grow back. This time around with dyeing my hair, I am more so nervous because I know that I am gonna have to use bleach, and I am gonna go to a hairdresser. I am gonna make an appointment. I won't tell you guys when because that's going to be another video, but I already have the hair color too, and I already know who's gonna do it. I already know how it's going to be. I think I'm more so scared of my hair not being the way that I want it to, but I honestly think that it's fine. And I always have this insecurity of mine because I feel as though, oh, it's not gonna be a good hair color, or what if people say something about my hair color and they don't like it? And it's like, bitch, first of all, fuck them. Second of all, you see how your hair, how you look with the hair color. You like it. So stop trying to jinx yourself. That's gonna happen this year. Dyeing my hair is gonna happen. I am very excited because it's the most dramatic thing that I've ever done. And I think that hopefully I'm gonna like it. I know I'm gonna like it. I can't say hopefully. I know I'm gonna like it. I know I'm gonna like it. I have to look at the hair color again. I'm gonna like it. Number eight, less procrastination. I feel like this is something that most people say in the new year, and I understand why. With me wanting to do YouTube consistently, working a full-time job, as well as going to school, procrastination is gonna have to be non-consistent. Wow. It's going to have to be non-existent. I will not have the time to procrastinate, and so I literally will have to be the Shia LaBeouf meme and just do it. I'm of course gonna try to be very soft on myself, because when I do procrastinate, I tend to have extreme criticism with myself, and so I just really want to not get too mean with myself. I do want to push myself,
But I don't want it to be mean, because why would I be mean to myself? That's just mean.
Number 9, take more videos and pictures. I'm currently participating in taking a picture and taking a video every day of the year, because I honestly believe that with that, I will become, again, more aware and more present within what's happening in my surroundings and just being present. I have a very difficult time being present. I've talked about this before with disassociation. I talked about it in the last episode, if you want to go click on that video where I talk more about my disassociation. But just an overview, I constantly feel as though I am not present within my own body, and sometimes it can happen for 5 to 10 minutes to 20 minutes or an hour. Sometimes it can be a whole day. Sometimes it can be a week or two, or sometimes it varies too, where I can feel more disassociative, if that makes sense, than other days, but there's still the feeling of disassociation throughout my day. And it's very annoying because I know I'm here, I recognize I'm here, but I don't feel like I'm here. And so when that happened, I really, really have to start touching my hands. That's what my therapist actually taught me. Caressing my face. Yeah. It really helps to self-touch a lot when I'm having those moments, because I'm like, okay, I'm here. Cool. Awesome. I'm great. Especially when my hands are cold, it's definitely a better feeling as well. With taking more pictures and videos, I can see how someone would be like, how does that correlate with each other? It just does. And the last one, number 10, take more road trips. I took a total of 3 road trips last year, I believe. I went to Santa Clara, Humboldt, and Santa Cruz Capitola. So I really enjoyed those 3 road trips. They're my solo road trips that I go on, that I decided last year that I wanted to start doing. And I want to do more this year. I really want to just go places that I usually wouldn't go, because I wouldn't have anybody to go with. I recognize that when it comes to my road trips, it's literally quality time with myself and going on a date basically with myself, and enjoying my time by myself. Oh shit. Wait, what? I've had this car for 9 months and I still don't know how it works sometimes. I haven't really had an idea exactly of where I want to go this year. I was thinking driving down to LA, to specifically Long Beach, so I can visit the CSU Long Beach campus, because that's kind of my dream school to go to. So I would really enjoy going down there, and also just kind of maybe spending a 4-day weekend or something down there to kind of get some idea of LA living. I've been to LA before, but never been to LA on my own, and so I think that would be a pretty cool experience. I also kind of want to do a Twilight road trip where I go to Forks, the Pacific Northwest, like, come on, man. And just thinking about going into the forest with the fucking trees. I love trees so much. Like, I cannot tell you how much I feel as though trees actually talk to me in their own language, but I understand in English. I don't know how that works, but it does. Maybe I'll do a trip up there. Maybe. I kind of want to go with someone with that one, but I don't know. I might do it myself. We'll see. I might not even stay here in California. I might go to fucking, I don't know, Arizona. There's nothing to do in Arizona, but actually, I can go to the fucking Grand Canyons. Yep. I have so many ideas now, but that takes like a lot of money and time. I was gonna
say effort too.
It takes a lot of effort, but I also feel like it will be a beautiful experience as well. I don't know, we'll see. Well, that's the end of this video. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. And also, if you can, and if you really, really feel special today, share this video with a friend or your grandma or your dog. Anyone that will watch. Thank you so much for watching. And until the next video, bye. Mwah.